Now, Japanese museums, for me, are a disappointment. And I'm saying this largely because I'm spoiled. I grew up in New York, and New York has pretty much the most amazing assortment of museums you could ever find. So I'm a little bit unimpressed by museums in general in Japan. That being said, there are a number of smaller, quirkier museums that are fascinating, like the Parasite Museum in Meguro I visited once before, and today, visiting the Tobacco and Salt Museum. Now, the second and fourth floors of these buildings are dedicated to tobacco, and are actually surprisingly interesting. The fourth floor is an ever-changing special exhibit room, and I've seen a lot of really cool exhibits. Right now, they're doing an exhibit on industrial design of cigarette packages. It's pretty cool. The second floor is the permanent exhibit about the history of tobacco in Japan. And surprisingly awesome, even if you don't smoke.
Lord, I smoked 100 cigarettes, waiting on your call, but it ain't come yet. I'm waiting for your footsteps in my hall, and I'm watching for this ash to fall. And while I'm counting my regrets, I'm gonna smoke 100 cigarettes. You know how I'm feeling. My porch light is on and I've unlocked my door. My eyes are red and my throat is sore. I check my mail and watch my phone.
Nothing really embodies the spirit of Olympic water polo more than cigarettes. Really, really, Mom. You bring your daughter to the tobacco museum. That was your plan, your educational plan for the day. Good job. Seems to be really enjoying the non-filtered exhibit. Good job to parenting there. So on the third floor, we have the history of salt production in Japan, which could be possibly is the most unexciting museum piece I've ever seen in my life. But for those of you who are curious about the history of salt production in Japan, this is the place for you. And you're a freak, by the way. But it exists. That's something, at least. Yes, salt. Exciting, fascinating world of salt. Ancient salt-making tools. Amazing. I will admit, though, this does make the Sony showroom a bit more impressive. Like PlayStation or something like that is a little bit more exciting than a large hunk of salt. But only barely. Only barely, because salt, I mean, come on. Who doesn't love salt? Oh wow, let's press the interactive exciting button. See what happens. Oh, flashing lights. As we see the approximation of the desalinization process in early Japan. This is so exciting. Ooh, so pretty. It's like Christmas and salt all together in one. Press that again. Wow, that's a big piece of salt. I have never wanted to lick anything more in my life than this enormous piece of salt. So much exciting tobacco and salt here. It's hard to control myself. All right, gift shop time. You can only imagine what they're selling there. Thank you.
Wow. A gift shop filled with nothing but salt and tobacco. Somehow I knew that would be the case. It's so much more awesome once you see it.
Tobacco leaf shaped cookies. Awesome.
That is so freaking adorable. And of course there is the smoking corner. How could there not be?
Japan is funny. In many ways, they still have a great degree of personal freedom that's been removed from the States due to a kind of nanny state way of thinking. Tobacco and smoking is obviously known to be bad for your health in Japan, but people don't stop people from smoking the way we do in the States. It's very much like if you want to screw with your health, all right, go for it, kind of view they have. Alcohol is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The concept of blue laws, like we have in some parts of the States, where alcohol is not for sale on Sunday or like before noon or something like that, this does not exist. That concept does not exist here. You can pretty much buy things to damage your body 24 hours a day with little government interference. Though, socially, tobacco is a lot different than it was even 5 or 6 years ago. Just a month or two ago, they finally removed all of the smoking corners from the train system. Basically, people here tolerate it a lot more than they do in other developed nations. And so pretty much everywhere you go, there's a smoking corner or a place to buy cigarettes. Cigarette vending machines are still everywhere. But now they have a special ID card called a TASPO card you have to register for in order to buy cigarettes from a vending machine. Point out as well that I get this question a lot about illicit substances here in Japan. Marijuana, for example, is incredibly illegal, very illegal, and if you try to procure it in this country, you're a moron. You're better off in a lot of other places in the world if that's what you're into. However, there are head shops and things like that in Tokyo, so it does exist. But if you do like the wacky tobacco, you're much better off anywhere else but Japan. I mean, go to Singapore for God's sake and chew gum and get caned and then think twice about breaking laws in foreign lands. And also, very new is this cafe just in front of the Tobacco Salt Museum. It's an incredibly, incredibly pink cafe, so unless you're pretty secure in your masculinity, I don't recommend coming here. With very delicious looking galettes and crepes and whatnot. Actually, proper crepes, not like the insane ice cream cone shitty concoctions they sell in Harajuku on the street. This is like a somewhat normal looking crepe. And actually pretty tasty. Salt. It's amazing. And orange salt. More amazing. And a large phallic object made of salt. Even more amazing.